This is a documentary film about individuals who dress up as Hollywood icons and congregate in front of Grauman's Chinese Theater or the Hollywood and Highland Complex, pose with tourists for photographs, suggesting tips. Initially, what brought me to the story first was the arrest of Freddy Krueger. Gerard, Hollywood Boulevard Freddy, was arrested for the first time for apparently stabbing a tourist, or so the media report went. At first I thought, wow, how bizarre, you know, characters are coming to life off the screen and actually stabbing people. I thought, how strange would it be to be stabbed by Freddy Krueger? Like, what sort of trauma would go on there? After spending some time down there, I saw there was a lot going on, and it was just really fascinating, and it pulled me in deeper as I went. At a certain point, it just got so damn strange and so interesting to me that I became physically addicted to the environment, and would joke about it being, these characters being like a narcotic, because their personalities were like that. Each of them were fascinating in their own ways. I mean, this is what these people do for a living. This is what their livelihood is, and some of them do very well. Some of them are clearing $300 to $500 a week. Some of them are making more than that. And it also comes in an age of American Idol in reality TV where people see more than ever. People can fantasize that, hey, that's me, and I could do this. I see some raw talent out there. I definitely see some charisma. I definitely see some potential in a few of them. Really, who is it that says you're an actor and you're not an actor? The ironic thing is these people are working, and that sort of plays into some of their individuals' problems, and it starts getting really complex really fast. Odd thing about that scene down there is the characters all call each other by their character name, and after a while, they, in their minds, have become Captain Jack Sparrow. I think a lot of what's going on here is that kind of psychosis. It took me a while to actually meet Gerard. I was out there shooting for about a month before our paths actually crossed. And I saw this guy one day wearing these very high-heeled rubber shoes that put him about 4 to 6 inches off the ground. And looked like a young kid to me. I later found out he was 38. He gave such a great interview. I did about an hour's worth of interview with him that day. It just pulled me in, and it pulled me in to him. He seemed to be an open book. He discussed his issues, his childhood abuse issues, and how he would escape by that by performing alone in his room. I note one thread with a lot of the characters is that a lot of them do seem to be in this perpetual state of suspended adolescence. For Gerard, I sense a lot of unresolved issues. All these things just kept happening to him that were bad. I mean, as I was shooting, he's arrested for the second time. And I just thought, God, this guy has such bad luck. I did actually help Gerard out. When I would see him on the street, I would take him to lunch, and I always try to get him to eat properly, and I don't think he really took the best care of himself. I think a lot of that's due to him working for 12, 14 hours a day out on the street, not hydrating himself, simple, basic things like that, and I obviously got a bit concerned. It's hard for me not to play a psychologist in the filmmaking process, but this movie is a lot more, it's about a lot more than psychology. Really, it's a movie about Hollywood, people coming to Hollywood to make it, to follow their dreams. They've had this dream from childhood. And I could really relate to that because I started making films when I was a kid and I had this vision. And I sort of relate to the characters in that respect. They're outside of the workaday world and creating jobs for themselves and making lots of money and not paying taxes. About a half hour into it, you're gonna stop laughing at them and you're gonna start seeing yourself in them, and then you're going to realize, wow, these people are doing better than I am.
But I must say one thing. Parimantana.
Thank you.
He's going to give you a ring for you. And you, give this gentleman. Okay?
Me? Give him?
Yes. It's an emerald. Look
okay,
at that ring.
What finger do you want it on, love?
That ring is very powerful. And I tell you what, it has a lot of power. Look at that ring one time, because it is an emerald. And it's very beautiful, and it's surrounded by gold.
8 a.m. David, this is Gerard. I'm sorry to be calling you so late, but I don't know if you knew. I don't know if I've been on the news again or whatever, but I got arrested again. The fucking cops decided to mess with me again out of personal discrimination or persecution, and it's for their own fucking fun. And I just got out, and I'm on my way back on the Sunset Bus. That footage of me asking the police if that claw is okay and safe, I need you to release just that clip to all the press, all the news programs, everything. I think they're going to try and go after me for possession of a weapon, deadly weapon again, even though they know it's freaking costume prop with no sharp edges at all. I've got some major, major lawsuits, I believe. Please help me and release that footage. I'll talk to you later. Give me a call as soon as you get this.
Sunday, 10:37 p.m.
Hey, Dave, as soon as you get this, can you please call these agents Tiana and Michael? If that would be cool, we don't know if we're going to be able to do the interview today because of the whole fact that Michael totally forgot about his photo shoot today. But he wanted to ask if there was any way that, if nothing else works out, if you can give him a ride.
Monday, 12:45 a.m.
Hey, Dave, you said to call around 10 o'clock now. I think you even said 10 or 10:30, but we're calling you at 10. We couldn't find a ride, so, he couldn't find a ride. So if you could help him out, that would be great.
Message deleted.
I think women love the suit. They love a guy in hard rubber. There's women who've come up and propositioned me, offered me money for the night, who have actually just come up and grabbed me, you know, and said, hey, he's not wearing a judge.
There was a woman here yesterday arrested on the boulevard. This was Carolyn Brown, an ex-actual girlfriend of mine. Carolyn Brown became involved with several characters out here. From what I know, one of them was I'll go by his name, Zorro. She was exclusively dating him. And after that, she became a free-for-all.
She was kind of weirding out on the boulevard anyway.
She took off her clothing, posed in front of cameras and photographers and video and whoever wanted to get a picture.
And she lays down on one of the stars, and Batman happened to be walking.